Morning, everybody. It's race day. Today we're going to Hillsboro Drag Strip in Hillsboro, Wisconsin. We're running their Spring Fling No Prep. You can tell I didn't get a lot of sleep last night. I'm taking my car. We're taking Jake's Fox Body, and really Jake's Fox Body will be the only one that's entered into the race. Unfortunately, even though this car was running for about a month before this race, I wasn't able to really test it much. We were supposed to go last weekend and it got rained out. The only testing I've been able to do is in Mexico, and that just, it's not enough to feel confident and feel safe. So we will be making some shakedowns on this, hopefully today. The car's been on only about 14 PSI so far, and it's still in one piece, so we'll see how today goes. So let's get started loading stuff up, and we'll see you there. Guys, we got Jake's car loaded up, got my car in tow, we're on our way to Hillsboro. Unfortunately, it's kind of starting to drizzle, rain. I don't know if we're going to be able to get this off today. I guess time will tell. They might have to push the race back, try to dry the track. You know, Hillsboro being kind of a outlaw track, being an old abandoned airstrip, they don't really have a lot of equipment to dry the track. They got to pretty well let Mother Nature do it besides, you know, driving up and down it. Maybe a little blowtorch at the line. They don't have like big jet dryers or anything like that, so we'll kind of see what today holds. If not, it sounds like they're going to push the race back to Sunday, which so it sounds like either way, you know, we'll be racing today. But if they push it back to Sunday, obviously the car count will be a lot different, so let's see what happens.
Bitch, I'm stylish. Glock talk, big t-shirt, Billy Eilish. Watch on my wrist, but I want that diamond. Niggas talk crazy when I pull up in sight. Mile high, run that shit back, bitch, I'm stylish. Glock talk, big t-shirt, Billy Eilish. Watch on my wrist, but I want that diamond. Niggas talk crazy when I pull up in sight. Mile high, fuck up first class, I'm the pilot. Put it in perspective, bitch, I got everything I wanted and some extra. I am not the type of turning into a detective. Got two on my own phone, barely even checked. Uber is the food I don't call, I just text. Next I don't care, my little bitch got a vest. Next out my Lexus, no backseat, so no best protection. No gas, this is no text. Hey, two pistols, 30s in the clip, these are Kimbos. Open and smack him in his mid, bitch, I'm Kimbo. You be throwing cash, just spit my little bitch, sucking dick for the crew. I got a bitch for the bitch.
Oh, hey. Bet you didn't expect to see me here. But you're expecting some sort of awesome dialogue from the track. We don't have any. Let's talk about it. So you've probably already seen some snippets from the track, and we've got video of us running, you know, especially from the starting line. But unfortunately, we kind of dropped the ball when it came to actually filming dialogue, coming up with commentary, and anything that had to do with in-car footage, really. The whole day was kind of a whirlwind. One is that we're pretty new to this whole gig, so we got to get better at that. And I'm going to work hard to get better at that. But two, we showed up at the track. When we showed up and, you know, we unstrapped Jake's car and it started to sprinkle. The sprinkle turned into what I would call a stereotypical rain. And we were kind of in this mood of like, how are they going to get this done? You know, this is going to get pushed to Sunday. So we were pretty relaxed and we were joking around with, you know, with the folks that had traveled there, and we weren't really super concerned with getting Jake's car ready. I already made the choice that my car wasn't going to be running competitively, so I was more worried about getting Jake's car lined out so that he could try to do something in small tire. So, you know, after kind of waiting out the rain, it kind of seemed like, you know, we were talking to Austin up at the starting line, and it the track started to come around. It started to come around really quick, and Tim fired up his car, made a test hit, and it looked good. And all of a sudden, it was like, okay, driver's meeting's in 15 minutes. So I felt a little bit like we had our pants at our ankles. We tried to get in one test hit before the driver's meeting. We were the last test hit that they were going to allow. It didn't go so hot, but you know, we had a little bit of data. Came back, looked at the data log. Drive shaft speed sensor wasn't working, front wheel speed sensor wasn't working, so it was hard for me to tell. Not that we couldn't figure it out kind of from the video, but it was hard for me to tell where we lost the tire on our first test hit. The test hit in general was just rough. You know, it looked like it drove left, and it's bad. So then we went into the driver's meeting. First round, we drew a kid named Dawson. He's from, I believe, Kentucky, Kansas City, something like that. You might even recognize the car. It was a super well-built car and fast. We drew him first round. And unfortunately, we forgot to turn on the bottle. So you can, as you can see from that round, you know, the car was slow. It is what it is, and that's to be expected when you don't turn on the bottle. And he went on to win the round, win the whole race in general in small tire, and I think he took runner up in big tire. And not to take anything away from him, but there wasn't a lot of cars on the property, probably mostly because of the weather, and I think too because of how early it was in the year. I think they try to do it to try to get one, a kind of more of a virgin surface, but two, to try to sneak in before all the other races kind of start to happen. And I think you find a lot of people, especially in Wisconsin, where their cars just aren't ready. Unfortunately, like my car, you know, had been running, had oil pressure and fire in the pipes for over a month, and I just couldn't get to the track to test it. So then we kind of just went into testing. We had a couple different runs with Jake's car, you know, and we had a grudge race set up with a Camaro. And we ended up winning that grudge race. It wasn't super stellar. A car wasn't acting like it was last year, but the surface wasn't great either. And we were commanding lower power to just make sure we would get down the track. We then later had another grudge race with a Mustang. He was from Indiana, a sharp looking car. Unfortunately, we lost that race, but it is what it is. It was mostly for fun. So that was kind of in between some of my practice rounds, but we'll kind of switch over to talking about my car. So it was before going to the track, I had made some pulls kind of on a closed course to kind of get an idea of what the car would do, mostly to kind of, I guess, road tune it, right? I'm trying to get the fuel map dialed in so that when I get to the track and I start turning up the boost, it's not way out in left field, and I'm within that plus or minus 5% of closed loop correction to make sure that, you know, it's got plenty of authority and it can take care of any sort of minor fueling changes. So I went up for the first lick I ever made in the car. Mostly, I just wanted to make sure it goes straight, make sure it feel good. In my head, I was only going to go 330 feet. I put it on the brake, made about 5 pounds of boost, let go of the button, and it went really well. The car went straight. It felt really good. I was leaving on 5 and I think I ramped into 10, right? So it was a dog. I think it went like 689 at, I can't remember what mile an hour. So it went down the track. It went straight. I didn't let out of it because it was feeling just fine. And I knew at that boost, you know, my fueling map should be really close. I came back and looked at the logs and everything looked great. So I ended up turning it up a little bit more. I think I left the starting line the same. And I targeted 15 pounds of boost. I went up there, you know, did my burnout. Jake said my first burnout was lacking. So I gave my best John Force impression for the second one, besides the fact that I didn't roll through on the start. Gave her a plenty good burnout. Let go of the button, and it clicked off. What was that, 669 at 107. So I was happy with that. Again, the car, it's almost like the car was on cruise control. You know, it might have, what we are finding, especially in the later tests, is, you know, the car would maybe start to spin the tire a little bit after the 60-foot, but it would gather itself up really quick, which is to be expected. You know, we're on low power, but otherwise it was pretty well. The tire was stuck, and I've got really, really old hand-me-down Mickeys on the car from Jake's car, because I didn't want to put brand new slicks on it and then have issues with the car and do 10 burnouts trying to figure out issues. I felt like it was bad luck to put brand new slicks on it. So I put on these used slicks. I'm lucky Jake let me use them. And it was doing all right. Got to the third pass, turned it up a little bit more. I was targeting 18 for my dome pressure. And I got to the end and I felt the car nose over. First, I was like, that seemed really weird, but it seemed controlled, but it was nose over. Right when I felt it, I let out. And then as I thought about it more, I was like, I'm not going to worry about it right now. This was, like I said, it was between doing Jake stuff, so we had a grudge race lined up. I had to get his car ready for, you know, but after thinking about it for a while, I'm like, you know what? I think I never raised my boost safeties from kind of where I set them up at the beginning of the season just to make sure. Essentially, to make sure that the wastegates were plumbed right so it wouldn't just get way out of hand. So it saw over 16 pounds of boost, which is what I had to set up for one of my safeties, and I reverted to wastegate, which makes sense. You know, I was targeting 18 pounds of dome pressure, should make about 18 pounds of boost. Otherwise, all the fueling looked really good. Went up for my last hit, and that pass went a 672. At 96 miles an hour because I let out. So, to me, metrics-wise, 60-foot, 330, I was on track to definitely go faster than my second pass, as to probably be expected. I ended up turning up the leave on my last pass, fourth pass that I made that day, and to 7 pounds of boost, and I targeted 20 out the back. So I wanted to kind of see where the fueling would be at. And for me, we're still definitely not leaning on the car. This should be no sweat for what I've got in the car. When I was pulling up to the line, I noticed that there was I think it was a dart, and I don't know my old Mopars very well, but it was kind of sitting up there. It was turned off. So I kind of went around and I went into the lane. Up until this time, I'd just been doing single passes just to make sure the car would go straight and the whole deal. Well, as I went past him, pulled into the burnout box, he fired his car back up, and he got in the lane next to me. So, you're on, right? So, did a burnout, backed up, you know, Austin flagged us. You know, I built boost. I saw 5 pounds of boost, at least 5 pounds of boost before I gave him the nod. He was pretty much at that point ready to switch to the next guy to make sure he was on the line. I was targeting 7, like I said. Let go of the button from the video, you know, 60 foot went really well. I got out about, I'm going to guess 150 maybe feet. I started to shake the tire. To the best of my knowledge, I never lifted it. I stayed in it. It didn't really, it was never felt uncontrollable, so I stayed in it. The tire gathered itself back up. And, you know, he kind of pulled on me when I was spinning the tire a little bit, and then when I was gathering them back up, I was pulling them in until right at the end, and we were pretty well matched in horsepower, and I was right at his rear bumper. It was just a test pass. It was just for fun, and I never really expected to race him. But, you know, I was like, maybe I should have hit the scramble just to see, but I kind of wanted to get my fueling map squared away. Unfortunately, you know, rookie mistake and the fluster that was trying to get up there for one, not only the final pass of my day, you know, everybody was kind of starting to wrap up and it was kind of a last minute decision. Let's go up there and let's make one more. I forgot to turn on my draggy, which is a bummer because I felt like that pass, you know, would have been a solid pass. It's fun to see progress, you know. Would it have been, you know, a 570 or something? No. You know, I got a long ways to go, and I got a lot of boost left to cram into this little two-valve. But I felt like it definitely would have been the fastest pass of the day. It felt like the fastest pass of the day. And unfortunately, not only did I forget to turn on my draggy, I forgot to data-log the pass. I kind of thought from the data-log, I wanted to check out fueling. But two, I kind of felt like I could have compared it to another data-log and kind of guessed kind of what the time would have been. Unfortunately, I forgot to do both. I was kind of caught up in the deal, I guess, with running him and trying to get the last pass in. Overall, I was super happy with how the car did. You know, it, after that, you know, no major leaks or anything to see, and I just drove back on the trailer. I drove around the pits a little bit with my kid on my lap. It was fun. I just think, in general, the takeaway for both Jake and I is we gotta slow down. We gotta make sure that we're on the same page and that we work out some of the minor kinks. I got a few minor kinks that I'm gonna work out. Nothing showstopper. I feel like I could go back to the track this weekend and just, you know, keep turning it up. But there are some tiny things that I want to tweak. You know, Jake, on the other hand, we got bigger things probably to work out with his car. But I don't see any reason why we can't get that back to being a competitive car around the area. And hopefully, you know, we'll be able to better document the next race that we go to. In the meantime, until the next race, because that'll be a ways out, I do have a couple of weekends that I've got kind of bookmarked for going testing, and hopefully when I do those, I can do more, you know, at track dialogue, kind of tell you what I'm thinking and, you know, how I'm tuning the car and what I'm looking for, and you can see how I progress through the day. But until then, keep your eyes out for an in-depth walk around of this thing. I want to kind of go in-depth and kind of tell you what's going on with the two-valve, and, you know, since it's a new build to the channel. And then the testing video is coming up, so make sure you like, comment, and share. And make sure you subscribe. Hit the bell so that the next video that we do, you can see it. Hopefully the next one's a little bit more entertaining. Have a good one.